Tony, the ultrasound has confirmed the lump is solid, so I'm suggesting we go ahead with the needle biopsy. What do you think?
Okay, then.
Good. I'll get you to lie down for me one more time. Now, you have a choice here. You can have a local, or you can proceed as you are. Up to you.
I'll have just the one needle, thanks.
You're going to brave it out, then?
Yep.
Good girl.
This is why we've seen the establishment of whānau rooms in hospitals, which goes some way towards recognising and addressing this need.
Wanting to have your mates and family around? That's not just a Maori thing.
She's not saying it is.
She's suggesting it's more important to you guys, like it's not to us.
Do you have a question there?
No, sorry. Get away.
Now, without the natural environment, the people cease to exist as Maori.
It's a workshop, not a lecture, so I can still ask questions.
This is the dimension that expresses the importance of language.
The results will be sent through to your GP and she'll call you in the next day or so.
Okay.
As you're a nurse, I mean, you'll know pretty much all there is to know about the biopsy and possible outcomes, but there are fact sheets I can give you if you think that'd help when talking it through with your partner.
Oh, he's in the business too, he's a doctor.
Right. You'll have all the support and understanding you could want then. You'll be keen to tell him how it went. All the best.
Thanks.
Tell me this is it.
For now. You can go to lunch if you want.
No, I was meaning you. I was hoping you could get back to theatre.
There's no need.
I know Justine's good, but she's not you, is she?
Quit fretting, Libby. It's all fine.
Except I feel so awful. I just suddenly realised that I didn't ask how long the surgery would take, and if there was any way...
Libby, enough! It's no big deal. When you called, the operation was almost over.
Oh, good. I don't feel so bad then.
And secondly, accepting Māori ownership and control over knowledge, language and customs, and recognises these as taonga. Also, accepting the right of Māori
something
to
special, our heritage.
Knowledge. Have you got a problem there?
No, we've got the taonga thing sorted, but I'm just trying to come to grips with how Māori needs are fundamentally different to any other patient.
He's not saying we shouldn't cater to cultural differences. He just wants to be clear what the differences are.
Oh, thanks, but I got the question the first time. Given you a bit of context, history first, okay?
Okay, and we'll begin into specifics later, right?
I thought I just said that.
Yeah, but he's an Australian. They can be a bit slow on the uptake.
Accepting Māori independence over thoughts and action, policy and delivery.
Hey. How's Fran?
Okay. Looks like her burn's healing.
Good.
Bit of a battle to get her to take the lithium, though. Might have to crush it up and lace her porridge.
Yeah, all a bit scary for her.
Yeah.
And you?
I'm fine. I couldn't give a toss about her, never have.
Is that what she's saying? She's just lashing out, Alice.
Mum thinks I would always shoot through when times were tough. Says I've always done that, even when I was a kid.
Well, she was needier than any of us realised.
It wouldn't have mattered how much I was there for her. It never would have been enough.
Well, no two ways about it. She was high maintenance. No wonder you left home so young.
You think I should have stayed? Done more for her?
No, you were a teenager. Had your own life to be getting on with.
It was a few years there where I hardly saw her.
Plenty of kids don't get on with their olds. I mean, look at me and Jake.
Yeah, but he was just rattling his cage. He never hated you.
Yeah, and you don't hate your mum.
I just ignored her.
You didn't know what was going on with her, Alice. Don't go beating yourself up over it.
My way of protecting myself was to make myself not care. I think I did too good a job. Because even though I now know she's ill, I don't think I can start caring. She's right. All I want to do is walk away.
Active protection may entail putting in additional resources so that Māori are able to enjoy equitable health status with non-Māori. Doctor?
Yes?
There's something you're not getting.
I get it. Ko tōku.
Ko tōku. Thanks.
Carry on.
Well, I've had the opportunity to work with some very multicultural communities, a mix of Italian, Greek, Asian and other minorities, all of whom have very specific cultural needs and issues. But as doctors today, we need to be aware of our...
That's not our focus here today. There are other workshops that deal with other cultures. Just check at reception.
Callum's just not getting the bicultural thing, that there needs to be an equal partnership between Māori and Pākehā.
Hang on, I get all that. The treaty in the past has been dishonoured and amends need to be made.
But why should Māori get preferential treatment?
Now you're putting words in my mouth, TK.
Okay, fine. He Pākehā kuari kē tēnā, ne?
Go ahead, got it all pen now.
Translation would be good here.
Engare, kei te tika tāku, he waha pakaru hoki.
Kā te tēnā? E poto te koe, nāi nei?
E hikai aranoku te.
He tauira ia nā kū, he hōmahi hohi nūmu. E whaki te kē koe.
How's things upstairs?
Oh, fine, thanks. How's Dr. Straton?
Very well.
Oh, that's good.
Crisis over, is it?
Sorry?
The big drama that Chris had to leave surgery for.
Oh, that. Yes, no, it's all fixed. I'm so glad that you weren't left in the lurch.
I'd rather you'd been there.
I tried to tell him that he could have given me the answer over the phone.
It wasn't an emergency at all?
Oh, no. He's just so conscientious, likes to be across everything, right there and then. A lot like me. I think that's why we work so well together. Take away coffee. Thanks.
One for the books, eh? Look, I got that she threw you out, but why?
She was all a bit by the book.
No, come on. When you were talking to her in Maori, what did you say?
I called you ignorant.
And she said?
You were her student, my colleague, that I should show some respect.
She was something. But you're right. She was a tad too cut and dried. Always brings out the worst in me.
Except I copped it.
For a while there, TK, it did look as though you were trying to tell her how to run her class.
Yes, because you weren't really listening to her.
I was so. Anyway, I got the feeling she said way too much respectful silence.
What, so you thought you'd just go and stir her up, huh?
Nothing like a little lively debate to get the blood going. So, you're going to get the T-shirt. I flunked cultural awareness.
Chris.
How did Clive's operation go? I've been meaning to catch up.
There was no emergency, was there?
Excuse me?
I spoke to Libby. What's going on?
Libby has no idea the level of urgency some matters have over others. If I say it was an emergency, that's what it was.
You've been handing over all these cases to me. Surgeries I would have expected you to jump at. It makes no sense.
Except I'm also running the hospital.
You would make time.
You know, I don't appreciate being questioned like this. If you're unhappy with the level of work and responsibility I've handed you, responsibility that you asked for,
it's not
then
that.
I will reevaluate your position here. I know I can find another surgeon, only too happy to take your place.
I am your colleague, Chris. I am simply trying to understand why you ran out on this operation and why you seem to be avoiding all other surgery.
Brenda, did you want to see me?
Oh, well, only if you've time.
No, I'm done here.